Okay, so what we are going to discuss today is market basket analysis, जिसको MBA भी बोलते हैं, MBA full form market basket analysis, और sometimes we also call it associative rules. ठीक है, associative rules. Okay, association या associative rules, what इसका सीधा ये मतलब है कि someone who purchases this will also purchase this, association. Okay, what we are trying to learn is association between products. If a person is purchasing product A, there is a probability that the person will also purchase product B. That is what is association rule. Okay, and how do we end up coming up with this conclusion? By analyzing the shopping carts of several customers. What the point? So before we proceed, there are some conceptual elements which we would like to learn. After that, we can just go deep into the problem. Okay, so what we are going to learn, majorly three things. One is the association rules. Number two is the a priori algorithm. Okay, and third one is how to implement this. What the point? So पहले तो सीधी सी बात है, we are going to learn the association rules, जो होता है कैसे होता है. Okay, this is basic mathematics, and then we have an algorithm called a priori algorithm, and then we will apply the same and see how a market basket analysis is done, for which I have already given you a data set. Okay, so I hope all of you are ready. Right, so first and foremost, what is association rule mining? We use it when we want to find the association between two objects in a set. Okay, for example, let us say whenever I go for shopping, for example, for my household grocery, whenever I go for shopping, I will definitely purchase some rice, some atta, and maybe some refined oil. Ye to compulsory rahega, namak bhi rahega. So whenever I am doing this purchasing, these are certain common rules. Matlab ye pata chal gaya ki what I am able to understand from this, that if I am purchasing rice, I will also purchase flour. Are you getting the point? So that is what is relation or association between objects. Okay, and then we find the frequent patterns in that. We are not talking about an isolated event, we are talking about frequent patterns. Jo regularly ho raha hai, bar bar ho raha hai. Getting the point? So this is what basic associative rule is used in these conditions. That is number one, there is association between objects. Number two, there is frequency in that. Okay, and then application, where do we apply this? We apply the association rules whenever we are doing something like market basket analysis, okay, or we are doing some clustering. Okay, the same rule can be applied for clustering also. Okay, and for classification, I think we can do it, right? Ki those who are purchasing this will also purchase this, that becomes a cluster. Okay, and then it can tell you what items do customers frequently buy together. Okay, and finally, in simple words, if this then this. Okay, isko agar ek word mein bola jaye to it is nothing but if the person is purchasing this then that. Okay, if this then that, ye relationship hai. Okay, and this is how your a priori algorithm also works, if this then that. Okay, then what are the use case scenarios? When do we use all this? You can read through this. Like for example, I can use this for changing the store layout according to trends. Okay, I can apply the same association rules for changing the store layout. If you are visiting any of the, you know, big enough retail stores, aap jaake dekho, do they keep the store layout uniform throughout? Ki wo beech beech mein shuffle karte rehte hain. They do that, right? Many a times we feel it's only for an aesthetic appeal, but we also, you know, there is a science behind that. There is a logic behind that. They try to figure out ki if a person is purchasing this, he will also like to purchase this. So wo dono cheezon ko saath mein rakh dete hain. We need not hunt for that and maybe miss kar jaye. You know what happens, like if you go to US, you will find out that most often the cases of beer are kept along with bags of chips. एक रैक में बियर रखा है तो दूसरे रैक में साथ में चिप्स भी रख दिया, पता है कि दे फिगर्ड आउट लाइक हूएवर इज परचेजिंग बियर विल आल्सो परचेज चिप्स, तो व्हाई शुड आई बॉदर हिम और ट्रबल हिम आस्किंग हिम टू फाइंड इट एवरीवेयर, ओके बगल में उठाओ खत्म, ओके तो दैट इज हाउ ऐसा हो सकता है अगर इफ आई एम कीपिंग इट समवेयर फार अवे he may you know miss it out and he may buy chips from some other store. Sorry, could be possible, aisa bhi ho sakta hai, okay, jahan chips aur beer dono saath milega I'll purchase there itself, okay, and then to understand the consumer behavior I can analyze the consumer behavior, ye bhi ho sakta hai, right, this analysis can be done for doing that, and then this can be done for doing a catalog design also. Right, I believe personally I can say this will work well while designing the menu of your restaurant, okay, this association rule, any person who purchases x will also purchase y, ye common hota hai, like for example let us say I have seen I come from a place where we are known for biryani, okay, so in Hyderabad we have a iconic place called Paradise, okay, so वहां पैराडाइज में क्या है कि यू नो हर जगह जहां भी देखो यू विल फाइंड पोस्टर्स जैसे बिरयानी टेस्ट गुड विद थम्स अप, ओके तो ये पोस्टर लगा रहता है बिरयानी टेस्ट गुड विद थम्स अप, तो व्हाट आर दे ट्राइंग टू डू, दे हैव फाउंड एन एसोसिएशन बिटवीन दोज पीपल हु बाय बिरयानी विल आल्सो फाइंड विल आल्सो प्रेफर थम्स अप, ये एसोसिएशन देखा उन्होंने एंड देन दे आर प्रमोटिंग द सेम एसोसिएशन टू अदर कंज्यूमर्स आल्सो, ओके तो अच्छा मुझे देख के लग रहा है कि अच्छा ठीक है बिरयानी विल टेस्ट बेटर इफ आई टेक थम्स अप आई मे आल्सो टेक अ थम्स अप, ओके एंड देन क्रॉस मार्केटिंग ऑन ऑनलाइन स्टोर्स, यू मस्ट हैव सीन दिस ऑन Amazon एंड Flipkart आल्सो अ लॉट, ओके आई परचेज दिस कस्टमर्स हु बॉट दिस आल्सो बॉट दिस, ओके दैट इज व्हाट इज एसोसिएशन रूल, ओके anyone, okay, so anyone who purchased this also purchased this, that is what they have done this association rule and you know they are recommending the same to the consumers, and what are the trending items customers buy, you also get to know the trending items, okay, and then you can see the best example I can give you is on Myntra, they give you you know stats, the same product is in 300 other baskets, market basket analysis, sorry, you know popularity is very simple, this is a very complex analysis what we are talking about, if I have to talk about popularity I can simply find the mode, statistical mode, are you getting, what is mode, highest frequency, so usse pata chal gaya popularity kya hai, so I don't need to do such kind of complex analysis, okay, so popularity is a very simple concept, mode nikalo khatam, like let us say I am running a store, main sirf janna chahta hu ki which is the most popular size of shirts, so agar if I just calculate the mode of every size, whichever shirt or whichever size is giving me the maximum mode, that's the most popular, I hope it makes sense, right, so this is much complex, much deeper, you'll get to know that, okay, and then customized emails with add-on sales, I can design my mail campaigns and all those things based on this, right, I'm just you know rushing through so that it's what do we say, exam point of view or such, it doesn't carry much significance, but without understanding the application, you know if I go deeper into it then you may not appreciate the concept. Now for example let us see, this is a basic market basket transactions, let us say, okay, in one basket I find bread and milk, in another basket I find bread, diapers, beer and eggs, in another basket I find milk, diapers, beer, cola, then you can see bread, milk, diapers, beer and bread, milk, diapers and cola, okay, and you can see whatever is red, okay, this is a very frequent combination, okay, so what we are trying to learn, okay, you can see what I say A then B, okay, and how do I calculate this B, there are two terms which I call support and confidence, okay, like if I understand I have two things A and B, A is called the antecedent, from here I am trying to go a bit into the algorithm, okay, A is called the antecedent and B is called the consequent, or to simplify if then, if A, then B. Getting the point? So the basic jargon, the basic syntax that goes this way. If A, then B. Okay. A is called the antecedent. B is called the consequent. Sound me? Like, if I go back to my previous example, let us say, it could be like, if diapers, then beer. I can come to a conclusion that those who purchase diaper may end up purchasing a beer also. I don't understand the logic ki diaper or beer mein kya connection hai, but you know, that's what the example says. Is this part clear? I'll go further. Okay, aage do terms hai what we call support and confidence. Okay, I'll come there. Just an example is given to you, like those who purchase, if computer, then antivirus. Are you getting the point? So if computer, then antivirus. I'm buying a computer, then there is a chance that I'll also buy an antivirus. Okay, for which there is 20% support and 60% confidence. Okay, now let us see. What do you understand by support and confidence? Okay, now 20% support means 20% transactions show antivirus software is bought with purchase of a computer. Matlab, if I look back into my transactions, 20% of the transactions demonstrate that those who purchased the computer also purchased the antivirus. Okay, and then confidence. Okay, what is confidence? 60% of customers who purchased antivirus software, who purchased antivirus software is bought with purchase of a computer. Matlab, when I am purchasing an antivirus, I am purchasing the antivirus along with a computer. Getting the difference? Jinhone computer kharida, unhone antivirus bhi kharida. Those who purchase computer also purchase an antivirus. That is support. That is support. Okay. Those who purchased antivirus bought it along with a computer. Matlab unhone isolation mein antivirus nahi kharida. Okay. They bought it as a combo kind of. Okay. I have 60% of that kind of customers. Matlab just example ke taur pe, they came to buy an antivirus. So unhone bola ki dekho antivirus alag se kharidoge $100 lagega. Computer aur antivirus saath mein kharido $150 mein aa gaya. Are you getting the point? So they ended up buying both the things. Okay, so I'll give you the calculation also, just for the sake of understanding what we are talking about support and what we are talking about confidence. I hope you are understanding the terminology. I'll come to the mathematical expressions. Terminology samajh mein aaya? Okay, just you have to understand the association. If A, then B. B ka support kitna hai? How much of support do I have? How much of confidence do I have? Support is a percentage of the number of transactions that are in our favor. Okay. And what is confidence? Confidence is when people are purchasing B. Okay. What are the percentage incidences when it was purchased along with A? Got the point? Okay. Now let's see. Coming to the basic mathematical jargon. Okay. Abhi tak theoretically samjha hoga ki what is the definition kind of. How do we calculate that? Okay, some maths is there. Okay, now we don't have to do the maths. Computer will do the maths. Your R will do the maths. Okay, but at least to know, if you know it, good enough. If you do not know, not a problem. Okay, it will not create any problem for your analysis. Okay, you don't have to do any of these calculations. You just have to understand. Okay. Now, how do I, first is support. How do I calculate the support for if A, then B? Okay. It is probability of A union B. Okay. Support is calculated as a probability of A union B. Okay. That is N A union B divided by the N number of things. Okay. Now you can just see. If the number of transactions with both A and B divided by the total number of transactions. Okay, you just have to find the number of transactions where both are happening and then divided by the total number of transactions. Okay, then you have confidence. Okay, confidence of if A then B. Okay, it is probability of A union B divided by probability of A. ओके बेसिक मैथ्स है ये जो यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड दिस इन योर चाइल्डहुड आल्सो ओके राइट नाउ यू डोंट हैव टू डू एनीथिंग इट्स जस्ट यू नीड टू नो व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ओके एंड देन यू हैव अनदर पैरामीटर विच वी कॉल लिफ्ट ओके लिफ्ट इज अगेन एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस ओनली probability of A union B divided by probability of A multiplied by probability of B. Okay? So, lift is an indicator of stronger association. Higher the lift and higher the association. And usually, we keep one as a benchmark for lift. When we are doing our calculations, for those transactions or those associations where the lift is 1 or above, we consider that a good association. Okay, ek se niche, if we have a lift less than 1, usually we don't include it in our analysis. Okay, ek se zyada hai, we consider that as a good lift. Fine. No need to write elaborate notes. If you want, I can share the slides also. My purpose is you should understand the conceptual element. That's it. Okay. You don't have to write every word I'm using. Sorry? Lift, matlab? See, lift. That's again a, just a metric. When I generate the output, you will get a lot of parameters. Okay. So just to know whether my analysis is good or not, we keep one element called lift. Nahin, aisa nahin hai, milaya nahin hai. Lift is a matrix which is used to see whether the association rule that I have generated is a good rule or not. When I, dekho, rule banane ke liye, when I'm making a rule, I will be using support and confidence. Okay. When I'm, for example, let us see, in my rule, I'm using only support and confidence. Ab ye rule achha hai ki nahi hai, kaise pata? Iske liye lift hota hai. Okay. So if the lift is greater than 1, I would say this is a good association. If the lift is less than 1, may not be a good association. Are you getting my point? So in my syntax, I'll use confidence and support while building the association rule. Association rule is developed. Achha hai ki nahi hai, kaise pata? Getting the point? So we'll be looking for these three things. These two. You're right. Okay. See, when both are occurring more number of times, you know, when numerator, when both are occurring more number of times, tabhi numerator bada hoga. Getting the point? That is when I'm finding both of them in more number of baskets. Tabhi ho raha. And when I come to the denominator, understand. When decimals are added together, it will give me a bigger number than multiplied together. Do decimal ko agar 0.5 plus 0.5 kitna hua? 1 hua. Add kiya. Okay. 0.5 multiplied by 0.5 kitna hua? 0.25. Just see the numerator. It is union. Union is and. Okay. Add ho gaya. And niche intersect this multiply ho raha hai. So obviously chota ho jayega. Getting the point? So this is pure mathematics. I didn't want to go deeper, but I need to know because I'm not calculating all these. You just need to know these are the terms. In my output, I need to know kya ja raha hai. Samajh mein? Okay. Chalo. Let us see an example. Okay. Whatever we have done, this is the example you can see. Okay. Assume I have 100 customers, 10 bought milk, 8 bought butter, 6 bought both of them. Okay. Association rule, bought milk, bought butter. Okay. Support, probability of milk and butter. Okay. That is 6 intersection, union 6 hai, and divided by 100. So it is 6%. And then confidence, support by probability of butter. Is tarah se bhi le sakte hai. Support उसी को हम मैंने सिंप्लीफाई कर दिया और कुछ नहीं. ओके, सपोर्ट बाय प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बटर, सो इट विल बी 0.7. दैट्स यू कैन सी दिस, इट्स इजी. ठीक है, फ्रॉम हियर यू कैन गेट टू नो द रिलेशंस आल्सो, कि सपोर्ट का, कॉन्फिडेंस का, लिफ्ट का क्या रिलेशन है. ओके, देयर इज अ रिलेशन आल्सो, यू कैन डिराइव दैट. सो नाउ, ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स गेट इनटू द एक्सरसाइज. I've given you a file which is groceries, okay?
Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle. What do you think?